25 book niches that you can sell on Amazon. What's going on, everybody? My name's Steve, and I've been selling books. I've been selling all different types of items on Amazon, on eBay for over 8 years. I quit my job working at the Cracker Barrel, delivering pizzas, and now I've been earning a full-time living, reselling, and doing a bunch of different things online for 8 years. So in today's video, you know, we're going to talk about selling books. And, you know, we all know that selling books is a great opportunity. You know, meet my buddy Avery. He's 26. He's done 1.3 million over the last year selling books. Here's my mom. Her name's Kathy, Mama Profit. She retired at 65, I think. Now she's 67. She does $3,000 to $5,000 a month, going to just a couple thrift stores. Retired. She flips books. So really anybody can do this. And I've been helping a lot of people, but one of the biggest things that people get caught up on is, you know, what types of books should I actually be looking for at the thrift store? And I've got a whole pile of books, and, you know, I just picked up a whole bunch of books to resell. I just got a delivery of 217 that I picked off of a reseller. Long story short, he was moving into a different business. But anyways, I picked out 25 niches that you should be on the lookout for at thrift stores, garage sales, auctions, flea markets. There's so many ways to find books. So let's just get right into this video. Oh, I do want to say, if you want to learn more about how to list, how to source, you know, how to use all the apps, all the things involved with a, you know, an Amazon book business, check the first link down below. My partner Avery and I, we put together a free training. So definitely check that out if you want to learn. So let's get started. We're going to go book by book, and we're going to talk about some of these various niches to be on the lookout for. So here's a really cool book that I found. And just so you know, most of these books are making anywhere from $5 to $30 profit. I'm not going to scan each one on this video because it's going to be like a 2-hour video, but I just want to share the different niches and the things that kind of click in my head when I'm out scanning, when I'm out looking for books, the things that really catch my attention that tend to do very well and make good money, because you got to pick specific books. First and foremost, I mostly 98% of the time deal with nonfiction, and I like to deal with really weird, odd, obscure, kind of niched down topics. And you're going to see that in this video. So here's one. This is the Beginner's Handbook, the Clock Repair Primer. Okay, this book's all about clocks, and in that book lot that I just picked up, there were a lot of books on how to repair clocks, different types of vintage clocks. This is a book from, it looks like probably from the 80s, yeah, 1989. If you ever find a book that doesn't have a barcode, now this is a barcode because this was an Amazon return right here, but if you can't find the barcode, you can just look up the name or type in the ISBN, but clock books do very, very well. Here's a book on abstract expressionism. So different types of books related to art do extremely well. Abstract art, different types of painting. Art books do very, very well. Now, you know, you can find interesting topics or interesting niches, but it doesn't necessarily mean that they're gonna be profitable. So you always wanna scan them, you always wanna look them up. I use the Amazon Seller app. I also use Scout IQ. You can check the link down below for a free 14-day trial. But I always scan, but there's certain topics that catch my eye. Painting is a good one. And this was a very interesting book right here. Next up, we have a book called Colonial Style, Creating Classic Interiors in Your Cape. I just sold a book a couple days ago that was very similar to this. It was all about Lakeview houses. So finding books that, you know, showcase different types of houses. You know, this is Colonial. The one I sold the other day was all about Lake House. So when you find an interesting niche, like a book on houses, but you dive even deeper to a sub niche like Colonial, a lot of these tend to do well. I don't remember what this one's selling for, but definitely an interesting niche. What it's like to be a bird. Bird books do fantastic. You know, I've sold a lot of books on how to identify books. How to identify birds. this video is all about how to identify books. But yeah, birds is a very, very deep niche. There's a lot of hobbyists that are passionate about this topic. Yeah, books on birds. Now here's a book called August Bourneville, My Theater Life. So this is kind of like a biography. Now, I don't sell tons of biographies, but if I ever see something that looks kind of vintage or old or just looks a little different, right? If it's something that is like maybe mainstream, you know, like this is an interesting book that I thought would do really well. This isn't a biography, but this is like an interesting book related to the story of Warren Buffett. Certain things like this look interesting, but they don't always do well if they're mass produced, although I don't think this is mass produced and that actually does have some value. It's a little slower of a seller. Try to stay away from like the mass produced biographies, especially the ones that are newer. A lot of those aren't gonna sell for a lot of money unless there just wasn't a lot printed, but this is an interesting find right here. Moving on. Here's a book called The Great Siege, Malta, 1565, Clash of Cultures. So books about different types of cultures and history tend to do very well. Again, you know, I can share with you the different niches and the different topics I'm going after, but ultimately you are gonna have to look them up. So you can download the Amazon Seller app, which is free, or Scout IQ, look them up. But this type of topic, this type of niche is very, very interesting. Different books about history. And again, you wanna get deep into the niche. So say the niche is history. Now we're diving deep into various cultures. And then this one's all about knights defend Western civilization against the, I don't even know how to pronounce it, but just interesting, very, very interesting stuff. Liquid Intelligence. Now I've sold a couple books related to bartending, related to liquor, making mixed drinks. For some reason, this one's, you know, doing decent. It's not a home run. Again, a lot of these books are making, you know, anywhere from $5 to $30 profit. So Liquid Intelligence, The Art and Science of the Perfect Cocktail. So you can tell these books are just a little different. They're a little unique. They're on specific topics, and that's the type of stuff you want to look for. Now, I knew this was going to be money right when I saw it because it's just a really, really weird book. Read the title on this one right here. Bouncer's Guide to Brawling, Dealing with a Sucker Punch, Street Fighter, and Ambusher. How many people are really looking for a book like this? Probably not a lot. Those are the types of books you want to go for. Well, how does that make sense? I thought the value is based on supply and demand. It is, but there's also, you know, there's the long tail effect. And, you know, there's probably not a lot of people selling this. And there's probably a select few who are willing to pay whatever it takes to get this book because for some reason they want to learn how to deal with a sucker punch. And then that's kind of interesting that there's a whole book on dealing with a sucker punch. But that's the type of stuff you want to look for. This thing's selling for a lot of money. I think this was selling for like 40 or 50 bucks. I don't remember. I looked it up. It was kind of crazy. Bend, Curl, Twist. Turn these fuzzy sticks into a dozen different creatures. So this is kind of like in the crafting niche right here. I've sold a lot of books on knitting, all different types of things in the crafting niche. I don't even know what you would call this, the fuzzy stick niche. But you could tell, like, we're in art, we're into crafts and supplies, and now we're diving deep into it. This is a really, really weird book. Look this thing up, ISBN number 978-1570-540-752. Interesting book right there. I was very surprised it was selling for so much. 100 Questions and Answers About Prostate Cancer, 5th edition. Books that discuss and share different ways to, you know, help you with health issues, you know, whether it could be, you know, it could be cancer, it could be diabetes, even books about, you know, obesity. I know that's like a little different into the diet niche, but health books tend to do very well. It depends if the book is like for example, this book might have been given to students possibly at a college. And anytime like a book is considered a textbook, even though this doesn't look like a textbook, it's usually going to be more money because these schools are charging an arm and a leg. But this one's doing pretty well, really good condition. Here's probably one of the craziest books that I found, and this is on mind control. Look at the author, look at the picture. This guy looks kind of crazy. Silva Mind Control, Key to Inner Kingdoms Through Psycho-Orientology, The New Science. You know, you might be thinking, who in the world's gonna want this book? Somebody does. It's different, it's odd, it's vintage, it's weird, it's obscure, it's a little crazy. Those are the things that you're gonna be looking for, and those are the things that are gonna be worth money. Now, I don't sell a lot of autograph books, but they do well, especially if it's like authentic, or it's authenticated, or it has some type of, I don't know how to say it, but this has a little sticker saying signed copy, and this is by Trevor Noah, Born a Crime, and looks like we got the autograph right there. So some of these will do well. I usually don't sell autographed books on Amazon. I'll usually put it on eBay. And of course, you never really know if it's a real autograph unless it has some type of seal of approval, which this one does. So there's probably gonna be a listing on Amazon for this, but keep an eye out for autographed books. And if you are going through books and they are autographed, you might wanna put them on eBay. Serious Money, The Art of Marketing Mutual Funds. So books around investing, books around money and finance, if they're not mass produced, if they're older, maybe if there weren't a ton published, can do very, very well. I've sold some of these types of books for 50, 70, 80 bucks. I haven't looked this one up yet, but again, I just did a deal and got 217 books from one of my trusted sources. So I know it's gonna be worth something. I'll have to look it up. Serious Money. Keep an eye out for books related to finance. Here's a study Bible. Believe it or not, a lot of study Bibles and different things related to this niche tend to do very, very well. This is called the Reformation Study Bible, English Standard Version. Now, a lot of these Bibles might have different versions. Make sure to look that up and make sure that you choose the right listing when you are trying to figure out what that item is going to be worth. But Bibles, great niche to look out for, the religion section. Complete Guide to Conjugating 12,000 French Verbs. Now, I haven't scored big time with books related to like different languages and stuff, but you can find some that for one reason or another, people like it. Maybe it's an older version. There's not a lot of supply. I think you're getting the pattern here. There's not a lot of people selling it. If there's a book that people want and there's not a lot of people selling it, there's not a lot in the market, you essentially determine what that book is going to be worth because there's not really many people selling it. This is the English edition. I have noticed that there's, again, just like the Bibles, there's different editions. Sometimes there's even first editions, although you're not going to find the listings usually on Amazon. But yeah, this book's all about French verbs. And again, it's not just like how to learn French, it's French verbs. So it's, you're diving deeper into a niche. It's the type of stuff you want to look for. Rocks and Minerals. Again, there's all different types of niches to focus on right here. The Peterson Field Guide series, Rocks and Minerals. Just a very interesting niche that you wanna be on the lookout for. Now, I don't know what to call this niche. I guess you can call it like fiction box sets. It's not a niche, but I like to sell fiction books. Remember I told you I sell 99 or 98% nonfiction. The 2% are gonna be fiction box sets. If you can find a box set like this that's complete, all you gotta do is shrink wrap it and throw it in a box, or if there's no like cover that's enclosing it, shrink wrap it, throw the label on the outside. Deborah Harkness, The All Souls Trilogy. This is selling really well right here, and a lot of these fiction books do sell really well, the box sets, so definitely be on the lookout for that. Books around war and history. Again, you don't want it to be very general. You want it to niche down. Maybe it's something specific to do with, you know, the Vietnam War. This is The Arming of Europe and the Making of the First World War. Things like this, they just look interesting. Now, it doesn't guarantee that it's going to be profitable, but this is the type of stuff that I am looking for. Here's another example. The Soul of a Tree, A Woodworker's Reflections. This just looks interesting right here. It looks interesting. Each plank can only have one ideal use. The woodworker must find this ideal use and create an object of utility to man, and if nature smiles, an object lasting beauty. George Nakashima. This is a nice book right here. This is a really, really nice book. The pages are made very, very well. It's the type of stuff you want to look out for. Woodworking is a great niche. I've sold so many books related to that. You know, books related to nursing books, how to draw blood, how to become a nurse. There's all different types of things related to nursing. Now, the thing with nursing books and just books related to, you know, the science field, they're hit or miss. I found that nursing books are like jackpot city, or don't even waste your time picking it up if someone gives it to you for free. It just depends on if the colleges and the students are using them. It depends how many people are selling it. These markets are just, they're either high or low, I found. But this one's decent. I think this was selling for like 20 or 30 bucks right there. Here's another textbook to be on the lookout for, statistics. I always tend to do well with math statistic books specifically. Also, geometry books tend to do very well. This is an intro to stats. Again, it's really going to depend upon how old the textbook is, how many people are selling it. You know, are the professors making the students get it? If so, Maybe it's a couple years old. Maybe a couple people want it. It just depends. You got to look it up. But I've definitely done well with stats books. Really niche down books related to health that are maybe alternative health methods tend to do well. This is called Ortho Molecular Medicine for Everyone, Mega Vitamin Therapeutics for Families and Physicians. So this is different. This isn't going to be something you're probably going to see when you walk into Barnes and Noble's right in the health section. This is really deep. This is a bit long tail, I would just assume. I don't know how fast this is selling. Again, it would be cool to, maybe I'll do another video looking them all up and talking about, you know, how I priced them and whatnot. But that's another example. Vintage kids books, children's books tend to do very well. Not all of them, it's hit or miss. But if I ever find one that looks like it's from like the 50s or 60s or 70s, I'll look it up. This is from 1969 by Wend and Harry Devlin. The book is called How Fletcher Was Hatched. So I think this was going for like 20 or 30 bucks when I looked it up recently. Some people just, they want to relive their childhood. They, you know, where are you going to find that book? Books on aircrafts, right? Fighter jets, airplanes, anything to do with just this topic right here. This is Hornets Over Kuwait, J.A. Stout. You know, if I ever saw this in a thrift store, I would automatically know there's a good chance of being worth money. It doesn't necessarily mean it's going to, but it's another example of a niche to be on the lookout for. Weird looking books and unique books that aren't mass produced related to spirituality, yoga, meditation. This book is going, I think this is going for like 40 or 50, maybe more. Yoga, Teacher's Toolbox by Joseph and Lillian LePage, Yoga Posture Cards. I mean, this is just unique. It's different. This isn't like the run-of-the-mill book that you're going to get. This is all about poses, and it's just very, very just different and unique, obscure. It's just the type of niche I'm looking for. I also do sell, the last one I'm going to talk about is I sell some of these, you know, for dummies books. It has to be something specific, something that's not so general. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but this is anatomy and physiology. I think this is only making like $4 or $5 profit right here. But scan the for dummies books. I wish I'd give you some more knowledge on that, but there's just certain topics for one reason or another that do very well with these. So it's probably not that much help, but don't pass on the for dummies, even though you'd think that they're mass produced. There's different editions, and some of them actually sell for like 17, 18, 19 bucks or more. And if you get it for a couple dollars, you can put $5, $6 in your pocket. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Again, I just handpicked 25 niches that I'm gonna be sending into Amazon FBA and selling in my business. There's thousands of niches, and at the end of the day, you really do have to scan the books, but learning to acquire an eye for what types of books sell well, and really what type of books sell well, it's the weird niches, the sub niches, the books that are a little different, vintage books, books that just, you just know they're not mass produced. Like, you're not gonna find thousands of them on the shelf, right? These are books that, they're just weird. They're different. They're hard to find. So hopefully this video helped. If it did, smash that like button. And again, if you want to learn more about how to sell books on Amazon, I do have a free series that I put out on my channel as well. It's like 6 hours. Just type in how to start an Amazon FBA book business, and that'll help. We have a free training, my partner and I, that you can check. I'll put links to that in the description. And go out there. Go to the thrift stores. Go to the garage sales. Start going to some auctions. Facebook Marketplace, Craigslist, library sales. I order pallets. I do deals with other resellers. I source a ton off of eBay, a ton of books and CDs and DVDs. I mean, that's been one of the main ways I've been sourcing lately. But there's just so much opportunity. And moving into 2022, 2023, you know, it's just such a great opportunity with all the craziness in the world. More people are shopping online. A lot of people might think, oh, Kindle books, digital books, that's the future. I agree that digital is the future, but when it comes to books, people love having a good hard book in their hand, and they just do well. I've been doing this for years, and I think it's gonna just continue to increase in popularity and just shopping online. So if you have any questions, drop a comment below. Again, you know, subscribe if you like these videos, or you have a question, leave a comment, hit that bell notification to see more videos in the future. And with that being said, much love, bye.